In the tinning method. Okay, our first color is going to be off-white. You want to do the belly, inside the mouth. For a good transparent effect, you can leave it off these bottom fins and put pearl instead, and it has a real nice effect. And maybe right here at the fin juncture, make sure you get that a little white. Here you want it to kind of fade down into the pen a little bit, just like I've done there. There's a few little black marks that you want to replicate on the pens, and they often not cover them up completely. Sometimes there's markings, but not so much on the lower jaw on this one. Towards the end of the mouth, there's some markings you may want to not cover up completely. You just missed a little light over it. You know, that doesn't mean you have to leave it blank. Just when you put the light on, make sure you don't put it on so heavy to cover your marks. Although even if you did, you can replicate it back in. But if it's already there, you can just basically trace over it if you don't put your paint on too heavy right on here, right in there. I mean, just enough to where you can see it. That's all you got to really worry about. Pearl in these areas too. Think about. Look at reference while you're doing it. Make sure we got the belly as good as we want to get. Make sure what you want to do, you want to fade up into the brown on the back, or a fade up on the side, I'm sorry. What it'll do is, what's already white, it'll whiten it up a little more, as long as you don't go heavy with it. Once I left these fins transparent, and I did do that on purpose. Hide the mouth also. Cover up the markings, and remember you can put it back in. fish however you have to. Make sure you get inside the mouth real good. Silver pearl. Okay, now we've got pearl here. Silver pearl. Rock pearl will work also. Go ahead and put it. Everywhere you have white, go ahead and put the pearl. Your gill right here. Everywhere you put your white, make sure you put a good coat of pearl on it, just to pearl it up. Like you would if you're putting on the iridescent, just to make sure you know you're putting enough on it. Go ahead and get your bottom fin. And remember, just everywhere you put the white. Side of fish, we missed a little bit of pearl. Remember, I could have painted these fins white, but to give them more of a transparent effect, I'm covering them with pearl, just a light misting of pearl. Yeah, get them from the front also. Pull them up real quick. Buy dark brown straight, or you can also mix a black with rich brown 50-50 and come up with the same exact thing. Either that or they're so close I can't tell them apart. What we want to do, you want to put it on to where you see the marks that are on the fish. You want to see the fish's markings get darker. And if you're afraid you're going to do the markings on the fish, like on the fins, be dark, you can go ahead and go back over those by themselves. Here on the main body, the fish is pretty dark anyway. What you're doing is you're pinning. darken up what you already see on the fish. It's the fins and everything. A good color for the back while you're at it. Kind of mobby looking. On the gill flap. Put him in as good as you can, sir. Put him in the marks that are already on the gill flap. Like I do on a crappie, you know, where I'm covering them up, I'm putting them back in. They're still there, you can see them, but they do need to be darker. So I'm going to go ahead and darken them back up. the white pearl may have to darken the back here. Then the alternative, which is to leave it. Spiny dorsal is darker than the soft dorsal. It is a little bit darker. Got some thin detail that I covered up with my pearl. But I didn't cover them up completely. In other words, I can still see them. So all I got to do is put them back in. Make sure you have your airbrush properly set. Close to how it was. Just a little bit of tail, there's a little bit of spotty. Okay. And look better than the real thing if you want it to. kind of like you would a, like fins on a rainbow trout, the way the spot in it. Similar to that. Now you can angle spray. And you can bring out some of the scales on the, spray or nothing, I hit head on. Make sure it's not too heavy. just want a hint of yellow on the back. And it's possible. While you're using this color, you want to go ahead and get your other pins also. As you get up towards the belly, you want it to fade out on the anal. That's the way they do in real life. Although some walleye, depending on where you catch them, they may have a solid yellow belly. Some of them are real dark. The water quality depends a lot, especially when it comes to a walleye. The water quality will make a difference on what color your fish is. Make sure you card real good so you don't get overspray where you don't want it. Put it on too dark. So you don't have to do that either. And your fins and then your seam on the back. Okay, now I've got a mixture, half and half, of yellow gold pearl and bright yellow. It's a half and half mixture of yellow gold pearl and bright yellow. Spots that are in between the bars. If you look, you can see like the bars, little rows of bars. And you want to hit those. And probably about a light coat. A light medium coat. You can't get carried away and put this on too hard, but you gotta remember it's got a pearl in it too. So I know this seems sort of tedious, and it is, but it does make for a good effect. Now they've also got a paint out now, which is a walleye yellow transparent pearl, and I'm thinking it's almost the same color, almost, or close to it. Now if something that the scales connect, you can almost run a straight line. But you want them broken up. You don't want to do them all that way. You don't want it to look like a zebra with stripes. So don't cover the brown if you can, any of the brown. And you don't even have to get all the marks. So you can break it up and just get some of them. You know, get 5 to 10 in a row, and then you can break up. And you can also use this as a way to break off the bell area, the transition area where the bell leads. Turns into I'm just running a straight line on both. There's nothing wrong with that. Almost every one, but you don't have to. And there's an area where it takes us out. You want to fade it out. You want to fade the spots out, so keep that in mind also. At least to the lateral line with this. Straight line. Some of them are almost like lines. Some of them aren't. Designate a stopping off point. Now for the chain light markings, you can almost see which ones to do. Probably looks a little better. little bit lighter. Rows of scales, and I just put a light thin screen right there in between the marks. That'll get too heavy there. Don't go above the lateral line. A lot of people don't even do this. A lot of people, after they put the yellow on, they darken their fins up. With a dark brown, let it go. But I want a little bit more yellow in my fish. On the face, you can use a little bit of this while we got it. It's a real good pearly yellow. I think they call it walleye yellow or something like that. And you can buy it pre-mixed. You don't have to have it mixed. I mean, you can buy it already mixed. So much with the gills. Maybe a ever so light misting over the back. And that sparkle really looks good. Decal on my fins, and if I don't bring them out, they'll be covered over. And I thought right now would be a good time to go ahead and bring some of them out, some of the main ones. There so I can see them, so but if I'm not careful, I might cover up a lot of that stuff. So they're not covered forever on the soft dorsal. I'll try not to get in the way. I know it's easier said than done. Remember earlier we already put the spotting on all our other pins. So this pedal pin is basically the last pin we've got to worry about. And this, you can even paint the pin white and put your decals back in. But spray the pins also, so it's going to add to the effect. It's going to really make them look a lot better. The spray, it will look almost kind of like dots. My airbrush. So you know it can't be wrong when you trace over Mother Nature. You know you can't go wrong. You're putting in all of what was already there. And that's something to remember. That if on bass or crappie, it has such a good effect because you're basically tracing over Mother Nature. Some black markings, kind of like saddle type markings. Different than what you see on a sauger. It's probably a good idea to go ahead and put them in now. Even every walleye is different as far as the tail markings. That's something to keep in mind also. Okay, now I'm going to handle spray brown has almost a greenish tint too, and that will help you. You want to be careful, you can over darken the back, and you sort of don't want to do that because we spent the time to put some markings on top on the mouth and stuff like that, and we don't want to necessarily kill all that out. Go along the back on both sides. I may even go ahead and do my peanuts first. I don't know. Go ahead and make a run or two. A lot of times, I'll hit the face of the peanuts as I'm going down. My first couple passes on the back, I'll hit the face of my, just the very bottom of my spiny dorsal fin. I don't worry so much about the anal fin. sprayed just a couple of passes. Because you don't want that yellow to get too dark. Just from the side of a couple of passes. And that's perfect. You want this to fade out just below the lateral line. Completely. Or just below the lateral line. Now the spiny dorsal is pretty dark. I think almost a Payne's gray would work for it. That's good enough right there. And just to highlight the soft dorsal from an extreme angle, I want to come in. And angle spray the tail. Just to highlight it, I want to get from an extreme angle. I'm going to go ahead and angle spray this for me. Just to give the fin some detail. And looking off though. Just enough to give detail. Now don't take much. That's about it, right there. There we go. Notice that the markings, to me, the dark markings, look almost a little pale. Well, what you can do, you may want to go down on your air pressure. Exhibit this to a different degree. Some of them almost have almost like lines. And you can replicate those. But not so much this one. Now up towards the lateral line you see some. You want to keep it confined. You don't want to get on the yellow because that has a bad effect. But I turned my air down even. Doing a reproduction, you put all these in. When you want to. optional, you know, you don't have to do it. But if you feel like your fish is, like maybe the darkness on the side is not pronounced enough, this will take care of it, for sure. There's even places on the collarbone you can dress up. Spots here and there if you think they need to be there. Way to the tail. As you can see, I went all the way to the tail with it, just faintly put in them dark lines that are already there. And you can get as meticulous as you want. You can trace exactly over the dark brown markings if you wanted to. Now even here on the face, I guess you can even darken up what's already dark. So as long as you got your airbrush turned down enough. Slightly traced over my dark markings that were already there. And this is optional, but I like to clarify a little bit. Clarify my markings. Now I might do this. If anything, I just do it out of habit. But now this is my dark brown again. But I try to stay right up just on the very tip. Darken the very outer edge. And those last two are very, very dark. Okay, now I'm back to my white, my off white. Now if you notice on a walleye, you notice on the walleye, I'd have to set the fin right up. Side. I'm gonna give the fish a little bit of color there. I don't know if you've noticed on your walleye. Now, some of them are more intense than others. It's not wrong to put a little bit of gill red on the lower jaw. You don't want to get carried away with it. Some people are not wrong up in here. A lot of people don't go up in there, but see, I'm just kind of just missing it slightly, ever so slightly. Good idea to go ahead and replicate that into your paint job. And I even went around in here with it. It's accurate. Some of them are real red face. I don't know exactly what you call it, but they have a lot of red around their face. Depending on how wide you got your mouth on your walleye, I don't believe that's going to make much difference. If his mouth was wider, you'd want to definitely, I've got my gill red. But I'm going to go ahead and take my gills. Now, any way you have to hold the fish to get to the gills, get them. That's the main thing that you get. You may have to turn the fish upside down or anything. Stick. Got on just like a grade stake. Shot screws to the back of it into the wood that's into the fish. Now I just hold the fish any way I've got to. The main thing is be careful. If you're not careful, you can really mess the fish up. You spill red on it or something like that. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing. Any way that you can see with your eye, you should be able to get your airbrush to it. They're pretty close. Now this goes for any fish you do. Any fish that you paint. The gills of all fish paint the same way. They've got an open mouth, and you've got to paint it. Just a little bit of deep olive. I mean, just a hair. And this is optional. But right here at the bottom of the fish where the yellow stalks and the upper belly meets, sometimes right in there I'll see a little bit of a, almost a trace of olive. Here again, it's optional. You want to look and have to look again to make sure you even see it. That is, even if you decide to use it. hair bit of it. Right here I have the lower cheek area. And let it even mix a little bit. Right here at the bottom of the cheek. Kind of blend in that with that red just a little. Now, not even enough to really see it. Color that I don't see put on a lot of walleye, but I see it every time I see them. It could be just the water clarity where I live, but I see it anyway, definitely is. And it's iridescent green. And I want it to stay right along the back. I don't want to get it on the fins though. And I want to put enough just to see a sparkle. Careful, you can run a fish with this stuff. And then you can see it on the gill plate, the upper gill plate, and the upper cheek area. And you don't want any of it below the lateral line. Some people put it even around the mouth area. About one spray. Okay, now we're going to gloss the fish. We clean the eye off. I've got lacquer thinner on Q-tip and I roll it in a paper towel. You want to make sure you clean the eye off. And then gloss the fish. Okay, first we set the paint with a gloss top coat. And all you want to do, you just want to put it on enough to set the paint. You don't want it to run. Hit the gill. Okay, now put on a little bit thicker. So we already set the paint. You want a decent wet look. Make sure your gills are done good, your lower jaw, your belly. Don't leave a spot unglossed. And this is how I paint my walleye, the titty method.